Spin me round again and rub my eyes. This can't be happening when busy streets amend.
I've had a bicuspid aortic valve, and I've known about that since college. That's something I was born with. And I was told eventually that would have to be taken care of. You know, I thought maybe into my 50s or 60s. So to find out that I would have to have open heart surgery at 32 was a pretty big shock.
The first words out of his mouth were, "It's not good." And I was astounded.
It was a big blow to me.
Shock was basically how I felt for the first few days.
Nothing really was ever tough for him. And I knew this was gonna be.
Initially, I don't think any of us thought of anything else all day.
He just knew what had to be done and went back and did it.
Here comes Thigpen again to Hoiberg! Wow!
He's so steady, and it's not about him. He's unflappable and plays every play. And, you know, you can't come up with enough adjectives to describe his play.
Hoiberg, another three! Wow!
It was just always a dream of mine to one day be able to maybe to get to the ultimate level. I know it's such a small portion of people that play sports get a chance to play at the professional level. It's fun to be able to compete against the best players in the world.
His feel for the game is so good. Always knows where everybody's going to be, and he knows when it's a good time for him to shoot it, when it's a good time to make the extra pass. I think his smarts, floor presence, and then his just his heart. It's just tough, gritty.
Because it is what you say.
You know, now I realize, you know, how fragile everything can be, and you know, you have to be prepared for anything in life.
He went into the surgery wanting to get through it. He had the right attitude going into it. He wanted to live. He wanted to see walk his daughter down the aisle, and you know, so he had that. It wasn't about basketball.
I guess you just gather the inner strength that you need. You do what you need to do at the time, and you just go forward. Well, what's next?
We realize how invasive procedure this is. In fact, one doctor told us that actually having a heart transplant is an easier procedure than what they did for me.
You do what you got to do, and it's almost like you get into a state of mind, and you got to be strong.
Initially, I couldn't do much at all. You know, I had to get help out of bed. You know, I couldn't stand up on my own. You know, I just basically had to walk up and down the hallway a couple times a day, and that was it for me. You know, you kind of take for granted, you know, little things like just being able to walk on your own. And, you know, at first I had to hold onto a wheelchair when I was walking, and I had tubes connected to me. What they say after surgery, the things you have to be most careful about is not overexerting yourself. They tell you can't lift 5 pounds. I got my pacemaker implanted. I can't lift my left arm over my head for a month, so I don't disrupt the wires. So there's a lot of little things that you really have to be careful about. You know, for one, just to be able to be active with the kids, you know, that's been hard. I mean, not be able to go out and play catch in the yard with Jack, or you know, picking up the twins, even pushing them on a swing. You know, I haven't been able to do much of that. When I found out about what I'd be going through, you know, the doctors have told me that I should be able to get back and play again and resume normal activity. So that's kind of what I'm looking towards in the future. You know, right now I'm not thinking much about that, but you know, in about 4 or 5, 6 months, whenever I can start getting active and maybe doing some contact drills again, I'll definitely think and be excited about coming back.
If he does decide to play basketball again, I think it's going to be scary every second he's out on that floor, every minute he's practicing.
He also has a very, very strong set of family values. And, you know, there's no secret that his family comes first in all of this. Whether that means having to give up competitive basketball, you know, I mean, that's one of the outcomes.
We have talked about how lucky it was that if last year was his last year, that he went out with such a great group and performed well throughout the year.
If he decides to play, hopefully there'll be a lot of people watching over him. And if he doesn't, perfectly fine with that.
I think what this procedure does for you, this whole process, is it kind of puts your life into perspective. You know, it makes you realize what's important in your life. You know, the little things that you may have taken for granted now seem much more important. You know, some of the things that used to really bother you, you know, doesn't bother you so much anymore. So it really does, this kind of situation, put your life in perspective.